Before we let you go, three more days to the brand new year, to the end of 2019, a decade has passed. Gotta ask you, who is your best signing of the decade? Who's your worst signing of the decade?
Wow.
Look.
You're gonna tell me what club and why you've selected.
There's a few. Yeah, I mean, I don't think you can pick one. I'm gonna just put that out there.
Okay.
But I've gone for value. And I think if you look at what Liverpool did with Coutinho, they bought him for £10 million and sold him for 120.
Your best signing of the decade.
And then became better.
Yeah.
As a result, and won the Champions League. I just think it's one of the most extraordinary pieces of business.
So it's the best bit of business of the decade, not the best signing of the decade.
Well, look, I've gone down that route.
Build it however you want.
Build it however you want.
All right, Michael, your best signing of the decade.
My best signing of the decade. I've gone for David Silva of Manchester City. He came in 2010, £24 million from Valencia. He's got 4 Premier League titles. He's got 2 FA Cups. He's got 4 League Cups. 2 PFA teams of the year. He's 33, and he seems to get better with age. Mm. There you go, enough said.
Yeah, it's a good choice. I'm going Virgil van Dijk, Liverpool. Yeah, cost a lot of money, but you look back, I think it's now cheap. He's taken them to win the Champions League, and this season he'll take them to win the Premier League.
I would have gone for Jamie Vardy, £1 million, and what he's done for Leicester so far.
You're just a bit cheap.
All right, the worst signing.
With respect, I need to
$1 million,
that.
$1 million for Jamie Vardy. I think that was a good deal.
Gone for value as well.
Yeah, see, there you go.
Pragmatic people, Dave. Worst signing of the decade.
Worst, or anyone that came to Man U after Ferguson left. The list is endless. Memphis Depay, Mkhitaryan, Schweinsteiger. But I'm mostly doing it because I know the producers all support Man United, so I'm doing it to wind
them up. Yeah, we have a few of them.
So is that what you've gone for there?
So if you had to pick one,
I'm going to say Memphis Depay, but with the caveat that he was stepping into the lion's den. So I kind of let him off.
Di Maria or Falcao?
I can't say Di Maria because I know that it's going to come out further down the line.
Oh, what are you, a mind reader?
All right, Michael, worst signing of the decade?
I've gone for Tottenham Hotspur's Vincent Janssen.
I'm surprised.
An absolute disgrace. You know, when he scored 56 goals for his previous few clubs in Holland, and then he came over to Tottenham Hotspur and got 2 goals in 3 years. And I used to just think, what is this guy doing on the football field when I watch Tottenham Hotspur? So it really hurt me being a Spurs fan, so he's mine. Yeah.
Gary.
And as Dave was the mind reader, I'm going Di Maria. When you consider having bought him, in the time he was at the club, he scored 3 league goals and they sold him for 20 million less. It cost 7 million a goal on his transfer fee for the club. So, you know, he's a talented player, let's be honest, Di Maria, but it didn't work out at Man United.
I'm surprised no one selected Alexis Sanchez. 3 goals in 32 appearances.
Yeah, but I think you've got to kind of give him credit for his Arsenal career, where he was very decent. Mm. And I think he came to a club, like I say, at Manchester United, where it was chaos all over the place.
Yeah. So. Got a question recruitment there. Okay, thank you very much, gents, for spending such a lovely Sunday morning with us here on Astro Super Sport.